Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is a problem from the Italian Math Olympiad in 2019. Pause the video if you want to give this problem a go, and when you're ready, we'll go through the solution. To begin this problem, we'll start by rearranging for p to be the difference of two squares, which we can then factorise as k plus q and k minus q. And given that p is prime and k plus q is bigger than k minus q, then it follows that k plus q must equal p and k minus q must equal 1. And if we minus these two equations from each other, then we have 2q is equal to p minus 1, or p is equal to 2q plus 1. Now, if we consider when p squared plus q to the n is a square number, then now we can write q to the n as the difference of two squares and once more factorize this as m plus p and m minus p. And once more, given that we know q is prime, we know both these expressions must be some power of q. And we know here that a must be bigger than b, which will be greater than or equal to 0. And we'll need to consider the case b equals 0 separately, since that will be a special case. But for now, we can just assume that b is greater than 0. And once more, we can minus these two equations from each other to have that 2p is q to the a minus q to the b. And we can recall earlier that we discovered p was 2q plus 1. So if we sub this into our equation we just found, we have 4q plus 2 is q to the a minus q to the b. And given that we can divide these three terms all by q, then it follows that we can also divide 2 by q, in which case, since q is prime, it follows that q is equal to 2. And hence, p must equal 5. And so next, we can go ahead and put this back into our equation over here. And so if we write 2 to the n as the difference of two squares, which we can factorize then as m minus 5 times m plus 5, then it follows that m plus 5 and m minus 5 must themselves both be powers of 2. And so again, if we minus these two equations from each other, we have that 10 is the difference of two powers of 2. And so since 5 is a factor of 10, then we must know 5 is also a factor of 2 to the a minus 2 to the b. But of course, the difference of two powers of 2 will always be even, except when b equals 0. But if b was 0, then we would have 2 to the power of a equals 11, which is nonsense. And so no solution exists. Now, we still haven't quite completed our proof, because now we have to consider the case when b is 0. Now, when b equals 0, m minus p will equal 1, and q to the power of a will equal q to the power of n. And we'll follow a similar method to last time, so we'll minus these two equations to show that 2p is q to the n minus 1. And once more, we'll sub back in p as 2q plus 1. We can then rearrange this as 3 equal to q to the n minus 4q. And so since we can take out a factor of q on the right side, then it follows that we must have q equal to 3. And q to the n minus 1 minus 4 will equal 1. But then this would be saying that 3 to some power is equal to 5, which again is also nonsense. And so we've proven for all possibilities that p squared plus q to the n can never be a square number. And so we're done.